And goodbye a lot of my factories. So tragic for the new Mongol Empire. Oh, they're closing in on my capital. Oh, that's scary. But yeah, the Axis are on point. It's like, forget France, Soviet Union is where it's at. It's their Reich. Lebensraum will go on forever. And again, they're quite kind of failing at the final push there, probably due to just not having enough troops. This is sad to watch, but I need to watch it because this kind of humbling will only make me stronger. Maybe. Bet that's what these guys are hoping. You don't really like playing world powers, Jake. Why? I just always find it more interesting to play smaller nations. The build-up is harder, you have to do a lot more with a lot less. Huh. They must be starving here. Interesting. Interesting. If I'd taken the Gone West approach, or even the Axis approach, how could things have been better? Actually, the Axis approach would be dangerous. The Soviets have so many here. Then again, the Soviets can't beat the Japanese. If Japan were part of the Axis and I pulled the trigger on Soviet Union, the Japanese would be able to come and flood through here. And I don't know if it's more about Japanese being able to push or just... Oh, jings, these guys are in a bad state. There are a lot of Soviets out there. Okay, so what? Italy declared war on Greece. Greece war guaranteed, probably? And now the war's gotten that bit more interesting. I don't think the Raj's involvement is suddenly going to turn things around here, though. But we'll see. My own participation has slumped, though, so even at the end of all this, I wouldn't be getting anything out of it. Interesting, though. Kinda wanna sit back and watch for a wee bit. Okay. This is a bit interesting. Where'd all the Japanese go? Feels like it's counter-offensive o'clock. Where did all the Japanese go? Maybe they had a load pulled into here and they just got cut off. Huh. Maybe it's time I got my war participation back. Make your way over to Beijing, lads. You guys... I mean, these lines can just go away. Participation where? Go south. Half the front line was Italians, Jake. They probably pulled out. Good old Italians. Alright. Let's see if we can't make something out of this. Should probably learn how to fly here as well. We need some flying horses. Don't know where all these factories are coming from, but I do like it. Where are all these factories coming from? High time we learned how to make some motorized. Four should do plenty. But weapons too is the main thing any of us need to figure out. Alright, time to go for it. I don't care too much about... Well, much really, but we need to take some stuff. Preferably not by going straight through the enemy into battle. You guys as well, you're going the taking the wrong approach here. This is sloppy. I know it's sloppy, but I'm still doing it. There's not that much in the way of worthwhile taking over here, but you are just one division, so I'll roll with it. We'll see how that does you. Jake, remember how you wanted to give up 10 minutes ago? I make no claims on that. Where did the Japanese go, though? Oh well, everybody's getting in on this. We can't be left out. Perhaps it is high time to get some more units. There. Ones should always be at the bottom, I think. Four of you? Sure, why not? It's a good number. Right. Yeah, my own war participation is tumbling down. I need to get it back through occupation. Who are the main ones? You got it, but both through occupation and through losses, not so much from bombing. Well, I'll take what I can get. Let's go for it. Jake, the tentacles on the map scared the Japs away. I don't think that would scare them so much. Come on, horses, you're meant to be fast. Alright, infrastructure and enemy air superiority not helping the situation. Okay, this is how we do it. This is how we get participation. Occupy the hell out of anything that can be occupied. This is going to take some probably overly intense micro, but it must be done. Now, the chance of me running into some resistance is high. Very high, in fact, but they can't have units everywhere. Well, they can, but they probably don't. I wonder if this is even going to work. I put my money on no. Get you down there and see how far that works out. Alright, with this I can be a bit more sloppy. Just generally get yourselves down. Beautiful, isn't it? And what about you guys? Would not be overly surprised at facing some resistance here, but hey. With desperation comes some interesting ideas. Let's see if that works out. Zorban pointing out to my lack of resources. Now I should probably be trading for them. I certainly should. I'm running too low on steel. And I got plenty of sieve factories, so Papa Stalin, attaboy. Not using my PP either, I should probably get on that. I love having a theorist. Don't think I need to limit my exports that much. Recovery rate or defense? Defense strikes me as more important. Okay, well, straight away here comes the resistance, but it's pathetic. They're Italians and they're well out of supply. Let's not maybe lose the area I fought so hard to get. Once you're done with them, please make your way over to Tangien. Actually, prior to that, make your way to Tangien. Sure, we can barely hurt him. But he can barely hurt us. Jake, how many achievements do you have? I think I have 7. I have 7. Most recently unlocked Transport Tycoon. How fitting for all that open TDD that I've been playing. Right, there were still you fellows, weren't there? Get yourselves down there, then I'll figure you out. Actually, no, that's a sloppy way of thinking it. There we go, just see what happens. No wait, no. What I did there was completely wrong. Interwar bomber, no. Ability to naval invade, yes. More important to get submarines first though. Soviet Union's still well on their way to capitulation, but okay, actually that's really bad, because even if I win here, if the Soviets capitulate, we lose. Or is that true? I mean, the United Kingdom is here, so they would still have to capitulate as well. 2 million Soviets dead. Oh, no need to be distraught about it. Let's get that war participation back. Oh heavens, this is ugly. This is beyond ugly. I know I gave you a task, but we have other important tasks here. This land going back to Chinese People's Republic is horrific. But at least this land is rightfully mine. And somehow... Okay, now you've fortified this, so I'm not about to take it anytime soon. But you know what? I'll keep myself busy. And then I'll be back for more. Nanjing, please. That's the spirit. This is horrific, but it was a stroke of luck for me that the Allies joined in. Almost too lucky, one could say. Yeah, this kind of makes a mockery of war and battle plans. But I gotta do what I gotta do. Thank Italy, Jake. They declared war on Greece. Now, who would have expected Italian involvement in Greece would be catastrophic for the Axis? Oh, I don't like the way this is going. Greece. They're going to do it again, aren't they? I'm going to blink and then Greece alone, like all of India and half of China. You know it to be true. Alright, you really want to hold on to Shanghai? Well, that's fine, but I'm going to surround you and stare at you menacingly. Soviet Union participation is still a bit scary, though. Those casualties. There's something to be said for me just deploying these units and then racing my way down. It's slightly more important than anything else I'm doing right now. And somebody should be making their way to Nanjing. Can you form Mongol Empire in Vanilla Hoi 4? Is this some sort of mod? I always play with the game completely unmodded, so... That's the kind of statement that, like, 5 years down the line I'm going to listen to whilst I'm playing with loads of mods, so... This is not modded. You can become the new Mongol Empire by becoming fascist. Becoming fascist is not something I'm overly a fan of doing in these playthroughs, because... Yeah, why exactly? It's a bit of an easy way out. I mean, honestly. But I needed manpower, there were no ifs or buts about it. Okay, quite a few of you have slowed down. Or come to the end of what I told you to do. Occupation is one of the only ways I'm going to be getting any war score around here, so please do it. Do me nicely. Now, even occupying one of these gives me one war score, and I need everything I can get here. This is so ugly. It's almost hurting me how ugly this is. But it must be done. Jake, where are the Japanese troops? I don't know! And they're not here. And they're not dead, are they? A lot of them did die, because that estimate used to be higher. They were a lot of them here, thanks to the Italians pushing through. And the Italians just dropped out. They got cut off and destroyed in Tibet. Otherwise, though, yeah, where are they? I'm kind of grateful for just rolling on through, but still. That boy ain't right. kind of to be expected, but still. Not liking how it goes to the Soviet Union, though, but there's a lot of things I don't like. This makes me a bit sad. Jake did a bunch of things to heavily hamstring himself, and he's still kicking the AI left, right, and center. Maybe they're stuck in their home islands. That's possible. Pressure CM. Could do with fewer enemies, not more. Could do with more war score, though. Or participation, rather. That occupation, though, is really mounting up. I'll get something out of this yet. It's a bit presumptuous of me to think that the Soviet Union is not going to just ravage me in that regard. But I must make attempts here. There, no, you can go south. You can clean that up. Just keep cleaning. It's like we're playing some kind of clean-up detail game here, I know, but needs must. Don't just let yourselves get cut off, though. That's dangerous. What secret weapons could we possibly have? It's a horse, but a bomb strapped to every leg. Oh, heck, I am having their capital. Don't know exactly how much I'm going to get for that. Quite a lot, as it happens. They got any more capitals that they want to give me? Hang on, wrong capital. That was the capital of, I'm not sure if they're specifically the PRC. I mean, that's what I would call them, but what do I know? Not a lot about Chinese. Everything I know about Asian cultures I learned from Hank Hill. Don't know what makes you go all the way back there. Do you think you're exiled? That's not how it goes. This could be bad, though. The Germans, the real enemies of all this, are causing me issues down there. Wipe them out. Whilst you help out where you can here. Is this how the Mongols invaded China? I think this is how the Mongols invaded China. Jake, there are no troops. You could use strategic redeployment to get more land faster. Huh, never even thought about strategically redeploying into enemy areas. Could it even be done? I think it can be done. I'm trying to grab a stationary unit and tell him to do something like that. You there, for example. No, doesn't appear to be possible. Regrettable. Jake, look at the Western Front. It's a little terrifying, but France is actually picking up the pieces here. So I don't think Germany will last too much longer. A nice part about this is that when the war ends, it'll be German corpses that people circle around, so I might be able to get a piece out of this. But I do get the feeling there's going to be a lot of untouchable here. As in, oh, it's PRC land, so you're not allowed it, something like that. I could totally see that happening. And I would get very, very sad about that. So that should be most of this taken care of. You're kind of wasting your time with that. If he wants to go and retake Nanning from me, then that's fine. I would be only too happy to march right back in and take it. No, he doesn't want to. Oh well. He really doesn't want to. Will Jake fight Super Hitler? What a great name, but no, I don't think I'll be fighting Super Hitler. Alright, what's happening up here? Not happy about how it's going to Soviet Union either, but the Soviet Union has the occupations here, and I haven't been doing jack around here lately. Despite having a healthy number of troops around here. Well, almost. Go do something. Cut off the enemy. Yep, one of the very slight advantages of cavalry is that it's faster. Alright, these are the guys I have sitting around doing a whole load of not much. Now we can at least encircle that. I think encircle loses a lot of meaning when you're using one horse to do it, but needs must. I'll take it. I owe so much to Italy. Thank you, Mussolini. Your splendid cock-up has saved me. And it really was splendid. It's not that we're coming out on top in terms of participation. We're still playing second fiddle to the Soviet Union. At least I got something. It's going to be hard to make our way over there. But I should keep someone here just to have my eyes on it. Because, yeah, that's never going to happen. Okay, I want the Great Shaman. This guy's probably dead, right? No, he's dead, right? If they want to make their way out of Fuzhou? Nah. Not that easy, unfortunately. It's still making me very sad that this land is not going to me. I want it. There, no, you can take care of these scraps. You please get on that. Any bit of score that I can worm out of this is score I want to take. Is China willing to give up land to you yet? There's a thought, but I highly doubt it. Yeah, they're not willing to give up core states. And, well, hang on, is this land core state? What is this? Heilung... Don't even think they can. Yeah, I reckon all of this is core state, damn the... Them being a puppet of Stalin is causing me a lot more headaches than I want it to. And he doesn't want to give anything to me because... unfair share of occupied territory. How much territory do I even occupy? One state. The audacity of me, I guess. Oh, these guys are asking to be cut off. You just keep them in there. Well, at least it's kind of nice having this extra speed. I'm gonna still opportunity to cut these fellows off. Since there's no enemy air superiority, that's not slowing me down per se, but the infrastructure isn't doing me any favours. Clearly, solution is to march on Moscow, Jake. The situation around Moscow is something to be concerned about, but the wonderful thing is that... Huh. Are they even doing anything around here? I wish I could ship some units over there and do something. But it's no easy task to get around there. Yeah, there's no fast way to get over there. It'd be nice to jump on Germany's core state, since that's what would make them lose out. These folks can almost be cut off. Almost. But almost isn't good enough. Are you willing to die yet? Not quite. Quarter of participation means quarter of land, maybe. Depends where I fall on the peace table. I think falling being a very operative word in that sense. Alright, you take that, then cut everything off. That should be the end of any resistance over there. Speaking of being cut off... Get our eyes on Busan. Well, sure, if you want to protect the wrong place, be my guest. I suspect a lot of the enemy have retreated over to here. Have I learned how to make submarines? Yeah, no, I'm still working on that. I need to learn how to naval invade, though. Enemy faction members will include Japan, German Reich, Italy, and Japan, so without an invasion into Japan, it's all for Connaught. Thank you, please. Just give me that. Jake, horses can't swim, what do? We're still figuring out how to naval invade. We'll manage it, trust me. We're just kind of a long way from figuring it out. I'll seem to take just about everything around here, though. Gotta get that participation, right? I'm like the loneliest man at the party, I just want to participate. I'm sure there's a way to gain participation if you just jump on and off of a huge victory point. Alright, well that eliminated these fellows. But where to go from here? Tragic. Well, when it comes to occupation, I've almost beaten the Soviet Union, but they're apparently they've occupied too much. And any occupations that happen over in Germany are going to massively buff up the score for the Allies, and there's nothing I can do to really influence that. There's no easy way for me to march over there, as far as I can see. I mean, I might be able to get military access to Turkey, and then I get through Greece. We're in the war together, right? You'd never give it to me. Well, maybe if I increased relations, but still. My cavalry aren't about to barge through that German line. I wonder if there's even any... German resistance? There must be. Yeah, hardly any, though. It's Hungarian. Finland wouldn't give it to me. You only get points once per VP, Jake. Oh, there you go. What did I know? Oh, still land to be taken, though. So I need to learn how to naval invade with horses. I've still got quite the army, so I reckon Japan won't fall so easily. Well, some very strange things have happened. Very strange indeed. But I'll roll with it. It's worked out for me after all. But I need to keep churning up that score. And I need these guys to not exist anymore. See that? I don't know why he decided to reinforce him when he really needs to hold on to Fushou. But I'll take it, because that kills the Japanese. And I max out on research slots, also rather nice. Not that it's that many research slots, but I'll take it. We're learning how to make submarines, we're learning how to naval invade. We can almost work on weapons 3, probably should have taken a focus on that. Might need to learn how to repair a thing or two. How are you going to launch a land invasion of Japan, Jake? We've got to learn how. And maybe build some submarines once I also learn how to do that. Right, but I should probably do some equipment effort so that I can learn how to make weapons 3 a bit faster. Alright, doesn't look like there's anything too harsh going on here. Right, if I told you how to make your way there, how would you do it? There's no real way through. I could improve relations with Turkey, and then military access my way through Greece. Romania is not involved in this, but they would give military access. I'm going to ask for that anyway, but I wouldn't be able to deploy from there. I would need to make my way to a faction. Oh, hello! France are doing something cool here. I'd have to get through both Turkey and you. No, we got Soviet Union here, but that's still not enough. Well, I can at least try. Because I have a bunch of units here, my super advanced ones, who aren't doing terribly much, so if they could kindly make their way over to, oh, I don't know, here. These ones appear to be a little busy. Jake moved capital to Ryukyu. You hear the daftest things, don't you? Right, I shouldn't make the AI's own mistake and abandon Fuzhou. I'll send a single solitary horse to it and see what happens. Right, unfortunately, they're still in the mountains. But as they stay there, their organization is still going to get utterly destroyed. If they make their way to a port, then that's a slight issue for me, but I can get there a lot faster than them. Of that I'm certain. Oh, that's rather nice. I took Beijing for myself. And the resistance strength is scarily high, so let's get a few suppression forces onto Beijing. It would be kind of nice to collect all of my pawns, as it were. Maybe get them all onto Beijing and figure out what's what. Except, of course, for these fellows, because they're just going to die if they attack there. And you still need to hold on to that, so you get to be exempt. That kind of takes you away from Operation Make Your Way Over Here. What about you? You also need to make your way over. What a strange outcome here. I did not imagine things to go this way in my wildest dreams. But they did, so I'll take it. Can you declare war on China, Jake? China is part of the faction, and they're in the war with me, so no, I cannot. I really wonder what's going to happen to all of this, though. These guys are almost ready to deploy as well. Hold on, didn't I? I guess I forgot to make all of you. But I still want a load of one horses. Turkey has joined Japan as our enemy. Well, that makes things a little easier for getting through Turkey. Surprised Italy have not capitulated yet. So we've got our extra horses to deploy. That's kind of good. What'll I use them for? I'm working on that. I think there'll be the Invasion of Japan Task Force. You know, as I figure that one out. Jake attacks Soviet Union. I cannot. Can't even leave their faction until this war is over. Then I'll figure things out. So it'll probably be a fair while until you guys get there. Alright, I can finally start producing submarines. Might as well nah, there's no real need to. I would like to figure out bombers though. There's a lot of things I'd like to figure out. Like how to build an atomic bomb. Oh, that's right. Fourteen ships is all I've got to work with. I think it's all I'm going to be able to work with because I need some submarines. I think at this point I am going to have to turn around to Uncle Stalin and say, never mind the steel. Knock off. Yeah, just two of those should be fine. But I need some oil. Might work out. 3 a year. Okay, I'm going to be waiting a while on these submarines. Let's make some more. Be an end of your supply. Okay, no. How did you even have supply to begin with? There are no ports here. Maybe they've just been navally invading. Whatever the case, they're going to die. 14 ships. How many horses is that? Let's find out. These are 3 horses. Wait, 1.5. That's scary. I can transport 10 horses over to Japan. I need a port and I need it fast. Almost tellingly, what I'm researching is only 10 capacity, so go figure. Haven't yet figured out how to do that. Wondering what is even worth researching at this point. I do want to figure out field hospitals. That's been on the to-do list for a long time because I've lost a scary number of divisions in all of this. And my war participation is falling because the Allies are now the ones making the occupations over in Europe. And then some. The Germans have overexerted themselves on the Soviet Union. At least that part's been fairly historical. They pushed into the Soviet Union really well, but they just couldn't make it through the mud. This part, though, maybe not, but France was never attacked here. Due to high world tension, they actually had a chance to build up and fight back, so the Germans won't take long before they capitulate, I imagine. The Italians halfway there, German Reich, not got much left. Oh, nice, my units have arrived here, but this makes life a little harder for me making my way through Turkey. And also supply is shot. Huh, well that's not easy. But maybe we could go through here. Because I have a feeling that they've concentrated their forces more here than anywhere else. So what if I just grab you guys and say, nah, we're taking a bit of a detour here. Iran... never gets any easier. Oh well, here's the shebang. Need to make my way through there somehow. Still haven't managed to puppet somebody and make them my own faction here. Would still love to do Bhutan nice and quickly, but they would just join the... they would join the Axis if I declared war on them now, that I'm almost certain. Never mind low supply, where are you getting any supply from? Just kill him to death, lads. Interestingly, we can pierce their armored divisions. Do they have a light tank around there? I'm going to assume so. Don't know what we're piercing them with. Our hooves? We just sharpened them hard enough? I know about the encryption-decryption. It takes a very short amount of time to research, thanks to... Thanks to my secret weapons. But then secret weapons can be used in a whole host of things. Are these guys willing to die yet? They still somehow have a touch of supply. It's actually a little dangerous, because if they took Fuzhou, then I would be in dire straits. Not a song. That's actually a bit useful. I would quite like to get some naval ability here. Belgium, okay. Everything's sorted out now then. Listen guys, are you having some kind of brain problems? Go trot your way in. I'm sure you can take on a bunch of Turks in the mountains. They've been sitting there for a while, they're probably entrenched, you're out of supply. Well, not out of supply, but you certainly have low supply. Oof, supply's awful actually. Huh, well I'll be damned, you might actually make something of this. And the fact that you're faster than the average horse gives me a bit of promise. Really, this was all 2 years too early. I would like my horses to have much better divisions and actually have some support with them. And I could do it now, but eh. Also, German Reich continues to push into the Soviet Union, but back home, they're in a lot of trouble. This is so weird, though. There clearly aren't many Germans defending here. I just wish I had units here ahead of time so that I could be the one pushing in, gaining the occupation war score. That's why I'm desperately plowing my way through Turkey here. But just because we have the massive advantage doesn't mean things are going to go too well for us. At least we have a very well accomplished Soviet general leading the charge here. Come on, you wimps. 44% attrition. Child's play. Crush them. Trebizond also looking a little too entrenched for my liking. Yeah, go figure. Mr. Generic General here. He'll keep us in our place. Maybe I'm going about this the wrong way. Make your way to Ankara. Take no prisoners. Rather nice that I'm actually not facing any resistance problems, so I can enjoy the fruits of Beijing. This is not so nice though, I don't even know what this guy's meant to do here. There's no easy opening. Well, thankfully all of our somewhat pathetic horses can actually resist a naval invasion here. But that... what is that anyway? I guess that's the naval dockyard? Well, I was hoping I could maybe destroy it. Nah, not gonna happen. Then again, maybe we should defend this. Maybe. That would have been clever, wouldn't it? Alright, I still need to figure out a naval invasion of my own, and I appear to be losing convoys. Trade and supplies chewing up too many of them. Is it even possible for me to invade? How are we doing on the submarine front? Well, I've learned how to naval invade, but have I learned how to have a single submarine? Oh! I do! I mean, I don't know if one submarine can escort me through the Sea of Japan. Trade and supply, 10 unused. Take no prisoners, but Jake, you really do need that extra manpower. Aye, this is true. But damn it, I want to get through and fight all these non-existent Germans. Okay, looks like there are Germans there, but they're hidden under the fog of war. I do admire the Soviet strategy of let them come, they're going to die in the end. This out of supply hurts, but come on, you guys can do it. I'm still probably producing plenty of guns. Yeah, more than I even need, I've got tons of infantry equipment. If anything, I should be making more units, but, eh. Something to think about in the future. Jake, name it Seahorse 1. Nice. Deserves an admiral. You just find the nearest guy, give him a badge and call him admiral. Make your way over there. Yeah, you're gonna have to get there without being sunk, or else there's no hope for us getting across. Now, here's a thought. How many can I even get across here? And how well defended is Japan? Oh, I thought I had it paused. Also, I think we have other naval invasions go. Okay, I thought you got sunk there, but you did not. That's good. Alright. Onwards to Ankara. Thanks for Ankara. Man, our war participation is crumbling here. Oh dear. I don't think I'm gonna have an easy time naval invading these guys. Just a hunch. But how could I do it? I don't have any port. Out of supply is going to murder me. They don't have any ports that seem easy to secure. Then again, Kansai's port never seems all that defended, does it? Hell, I could at least test the waters, couldn't I? Six of you should be enough. Make me proud. I'd rather, frankly, you just took one step. Go for it. Jake, you shouldn't invade from Korea. You will occupy in the name of Soviet Union. Is that so? Well, my options are very limited. Besides, what does it matter? It's still my occupation score. Oh, you guys still have a front line, don't you? Forget that nonsense. You guys are under my special orders. Make your way to Greece. This is beyond terrible in so many ways. That guy must be dead. Let's just kill him. Make your way back to Beijing, though. I don't want any nasty resistance men popping up. Take an unorthodox route in, maybe? He's going to march in and dutz there. And he's actually going to be a little faster than me. But I'll slow him down. It's mountainous, so I'd far rather be the defender. We'll just delay him for a short while. We make our way in. Oh, wow, okay, he's got nothing to resist us with. I should have a bit more faith in my cavalry. There is no defense against what I'm bringing to the table. Jake, might be an idea to use that sub. Not yet. Can't risk losing it prematurely. So, unfortunately, I'm not about to plow through anything here. So, it might be better for us just to have a tiny battle plan. With a tiny plan. A battle one, if you will. Actually, forget that plan.